2018 Ducati Scrambler 1100 Sport Test. Back in 2014, Ducati unveiled its retro-themed Scrambler line to the world and caused quite the industry-wide commotion with a plucky new standard bike. Ducati made a concerted effort to bring more motorcyclists into the fold, and the Scrambler has proven to be a potent platform to do just that. Beginning with the reasonably priced 803cc L-twin-powered Scrambler Icon, the lineup has evolved quite a bit in just a few short years, expanding to include the off-roadable desert sled, the sporty cafe racer, and the entry-level 400cc Scrambler 62. These variants cleverly filled every available niche that the Scrambler could weave its way into. The Bologna-based brand is synonymous with undeniably attractive high-performance motorcycles that, for better or worse, often have their race lineage unapologetically placed at the forefront of design. The Scrambler isn't that bike, it never was that bike. It has taken a refreshing, happy-go-lucky approach to the two-wheeled lifestyle with ease of use as its underpinning value. It shouldn't come as a shock that a brand held equal parts high esteem for its performance focus and styling prowess by the unwavering Ducati's eye would be able to capitalize on the retro revival trend to the tune of 46,000 Scramblers out on the road to date. Now, we see the next evolution with the 2018 Ducati Scrambler 1100 taking the top step among its spunky brethren. The 803cc and 399cc Scramblers have done a fine job of satiating riders with shorter inseams, new riders, and those who want a casual standard bike. However, larger and more experienced riders might have found that package was wanting regarding power and comfort. The 2018 Ducati Scrambler 1100 is bigger in every measurable way, complete with a new chassis, new engine, and a host of electronics. Still, it retains the line's core principles and aims to expand its demographic reach. Above all, Ducati engineers kept that inherent rideability within the Scrambler lineup. The Scrambler 1100 is a more mature machine, without becoming cumbersome or unmanageably powerful. It's as if we waved goodbye to the Scrambler icon 4 years ago, watched it venture off into the world, get an education, have a few relationships, take a few knocks, and meet some interesting people before coming home a mature, well-rounded citizen that hasn't lost its penchant for a good time. The new Scrambler is available in three flavors: the standard Scrambler 1100, $12,995, special, $14,295, and sport, $14,995. The only differences are suspension, wheels, colors, and component finishes. Outside of that, they are identical machines. Standard equipment includes three engine modes as well as Bosch 9.1 mpimu supported four-level adjustable traction control, and cornering apps that can't be disabled, oh, and self-cancelling turn signals. The standard and special make use of a fully adjustable 45mm Masoki fork accompanied by a Kabar shock with spring preload and rebound damping adjustment. In contrast, the sport we tested boasts Olin's units with the same adjustment options, with a beefy 48mm inverted fork. The standard and sport share 10-spoke alloy wheels, with the sport enjoying a few additional machined details. Meanwhile, the special features true to Scrambler form wire-spoke wheels. Also, the standard model sees slightly taller handlebars, while the other models feature a lower bend bar. Powering the new Scrambler line is the 1079cc air-forward-slash-oil-cooled Desmodieu engine once found in the now-defunct Monster 1100 Evo. Ducati did much more than simply slap the two-valve engine into the new Scrambler. The big L-twin now has a new twin-spark head, single 55mm throttle body with ride-by-wire throttle, and new gearing. In all, the primary direct commonalities between the Scrambler 1100 and the Monster 1100 motors are the pistons, rods, belts, and desmodromic valve train. A step or two away from the Monster's sporting inclination, these changes are designed to fill its friendly scrambler role.